Utah. It has a lot to be proud of. It's regarded by many as a beacon on a hill, an ensign to all nations. It's known to be the state representing the quintessential rugged pioneer spirit and core American values. Every year, Utah celebrates a state holiday on the 24th of July, the day Brigham Young stood looking over the valley in 1847 and proclaimed, "This is the right place." On October 6, 2014, Utahns were shocked to hear the news. The U.S. Supreme Court refused to hear their case. The issue? Who defines marriage for the people of Utah? The people? Or activist judges in federal courts? Utah's Governor Gary Herbert and Attorney General Sean Reyes, both Republicans, soon stood before news cameras and the world, declaring that same-sex marriage is now the law of the land in Utah. The Utah Pride Festival took place in Salt Lake City earlier in June of this year. For those of you who missed it, enjoy the party and consider, is this the future of Utah?
Should be threatening the institution of marriage.
Okay, I'm Laurie Wood, and this is my wife, Cody Partridge.
Hey.
And we are plaintiffs in the fight against Amendment 3 here in Utah.
As a person who's lived in New York City for 25 years, you can't imagine that something like this would and could happen in Salt Lake City. The amount of children that I saw walking through this parade was mind-boggling to me. I mean, as a kid growing up, I can't imagine ever have been taking part in something like this.
Well, the definition of marriage by nature has been changing over the past, like, thousands of years.
Blessed on this day, all men, all women, and all others.
Their message is just to love, baby, is what it's all about. No shame, no guilt is what this is. We're here to preach love for one another.
We certainly won't turn away amazing donors like our friends at Overstock who contributed $50,000 to restore our humanity. We appreciate that kind of support, we really do. But that's also kind of, it's the community, it's the voice of the businesses as well.
And listen, you can this time Lions Bank.
So people who are fighting it now, those are the people who are not educated. They don't genuinely know the LGBT community.
People don't know enough gay people.
Right, that's all they need. They just need to know someone.
And morality is, that's not what we're talking about here. And people just need to know more people to break down those barriers. And we have a hard time in our culture distinguishing between doctrine and practice and culture. But I am very convinced that this is right, this is good, this is something that the church will change its mind on, in my opinion.
As the eyes of the nation focus on Utah, its people will define much more than marriage. They'll be defining themselves.